Here goes the Bristol Blenheim 1F. This is one of the most outstanding historic aircraft restorations of recent years. This machine was built in Canada by the Fairchild Company as a Bolingbroke. That was the name for the Canadian-built Blenheim. Here comes the Blenheim 1F, in from the right. The beautiful sound there of the two Bristol Mercury 20 nine-cylinder air-cooled engines. Some 810 horsepower. This aircraft, when it was first built, and indeed when it was first restored, flying again in 1993, was a long-nosed Blenheim 4 variant. And as such, it flew 10 years until 2003, when a landing incident unfortunately put pay to that. But pleasingly, it was to rise again, thanks to the efforts of the aircraft restoration company in Duxford, and, as we were talking about earlier, the members of the Blenheim Society, who for many years have raised significant funds to back up the restoration and operation of this aircraft. The decision was taken to restore it as a Mark 1 Blenheim with the short nose. For that, they had to have a nose section. They found one that had been converted post-war into, of all things, an electric bubble car. Thank you. painstaking effort to rebuild and reconfigure the aircraft, but it reached fruition on the 20th of November last year when John Romain took it for its maiden flight. And it's been finished in the markings of a Blenheim 1F fighter variant in service with number 23 squadron in late 1939 and early 1940, specifically an aircraft with serial L6739. Identity is very appropriate because it was the serial worn by the Blenheim from which the nose was taken that became the bubble car and which is now fully restored and fitted to this aircraft. More Blenheims were in service upon the outbreak of World War II on the 3rd of September 1939 than any other Royal Air Force type. It had its roots in a private venture design developed as a fast executive transport for Lord Rothermere, the owner of the Daily Mail. It was presented to the nation under the name Britain First, and it attracted significant attention, being as it was quicker than many contemporary fighters and bombers. It was ordered as a light bomber, and as the Blenheim 1, deliveries to number 114 squadron at RAF Witten near Huntingdon started in 1937. It replaced the Hawker Hind as the RAF's primary light bomber. It proved a significant advance in terms of performance and capability. But they also saw potential in the Blenheim as a long-range fighter. It has a Blenheim 1F fighter variant that this aircraft now appears. Ventral gun pack, 4.303-inch Browning machine guns was added. Developed by the workshops at the Southern Railway in Ashford. The aircraft about to perform its final pass now. Blenheim flies in salute to the heroism throughout World War II of Blenheim crews, whether the fighter, bomber, or coastal roles. And by the outbreak of war, the aircraft, which had been seen as such an advance just a few short years earlier, had now become rather outmoded. Blenheims were some of the first RAF aircraft to go into action, in fact, the first RAF aircraft to go into action over Germany. Throughout hostilities, wherever Blenheims flew, they flew heroically. Often, however, outclassed by enemy defences. Final solo pass then from the aircraft restoration company's Bristol Blenheim 1F. us a very special contribution from the operators of those three aircraft, from the Aircraft Restoration Company, from Peter Basher, and from Maurice Hammond's Hardwick Warbirds.
Then, from the left, break off this pass, the Blenheim, the Hurricane, and the Mustang.
In the Blenheim, Carl Schofield flying the Hurricane, and Maurice Hammond his Mustang.